this is Shana. And now what? I got one line in. Oh, I love you.
You know you're going to do it. All right. Okay, here we go.
What's wrong, honey? Look at my eyes. We met at work. Shana started helping our previous boss. So she came to the office and started helping us. And thought, man, that's kind of a cute girl working across the trailer park at the time. There was a nice, lovely porch in between us that every now and then my office actually interlined with hers, I'm pretty sure. Could leave the doors open and kind of flirt throughout the day with the doors open across. So.
Wave across the porch. Do you call that dating? Because then
we really did that.
So, I was in an apartment over on Oak Street. And Ryan came home from prom. They had just loaded out prom. And was driving by the Super Save on Main Street. And there's the litter of 11 lab puppies. And he called me. He's like, I'm going to get a dog. So we bought Zephyr. And then
took her to my mom's house. Went and showed my mom. About the same exact reaction of, what are y'all gonna do with the dog? We said, well, we're not really sure, but we're gonna figure it out. As a matter of fact, we might go back and get her your little brother. We went back and we got Zeus, built a little pen at Live Oak for them to hang out during the day, and then we'd sneak them in at night. And it was finally like, okay, these little puppy labs are starting to become big labs. So we called Wesley and said, I need to buy a house. Thanks to Zeus and Zephyr, this is where we're at. So I bought the house, moved in June. Shana's still at the apartment. So we're going back and forth, and it's like, well, this isn't working out. Like, she was coming over here, and I wasn't wanting her to leave. But then we're paying for the apartment at the same time, so.
And so I think I had to go to the grocery store. But when I got here, on the side door, there was a note that said, it's like, will you move in with me? Come in through this door if yes, otherwise you can go to the front door.
I was fixing to say.
I followed you into the park, through the jungle, through the dark. Girl, I never loved one like you.
All the other doors in the house had stipulations or ideas or rules, perhaps, if you will, not necessarily like strict rules, but like I said, this is your closet, this one's mine. Chloe can mess up her room, but the first one was, if you accept to move in, you may enter in this door. If not, please go around to the front and ring the doorbell. So we moved in together, and then I guess it goes on for about almost a year and a half, perhaps, and still, Callie and Tara. When are you going to pop the questions?
Tiffany and
everybody really just kind of wanting to know. And of course, like she said earlier, we work on Ryan time a lot of the times. I wanted to work really hard at not, I didn't want her to have any idea that it was coming. And I had booked a trip to Napa Valley in California, and like a three or four day trip. We were going to go to a bed and breakfast, and of course there was a train involved, so there was some slight...
He had an ulterior motive.
So I surprised her with the trip. We got on a plane one night and we flew into San Francisco, rented the car and went to the bed and breakfast. And we went on the train ride. We had lunch on the train in the dome car. And then I just, well, she'll tell you, I couldn't sit still. I was like sweating. I think I went to the bathroom like 6 times. I had to, because I couldn't still. Kept getting up, sitting down. And
definitely was not himself. But.
No.
So we decided we're going to go, you know, look around then. And he had taken his coat off, but he started to put it back on, and we got to go to the other part of the train. And I was like, if you're so hot, why are you putting your jacket back on? Why don't you just leave your coat here? He was like, no. We ended up at the back of the observation car on the tail end. And
Yeah.
Oh, I'm witnessing something.
Oh my!
And I turned around and I started to get on one knee, and then you had this lady standing between Shana and I that is just frantically screaming with excitement of, oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm witnessing something like this.
Oh, I'm so excited.
So thrilled. She's like looking for the professional camera. She thinks she's on some reality show or something,
you
if something's happened.
This on TV.
You
guys
see this on TV. I'm
excited. We got waves and congratulations and honks from the engineer and all sorts of stuff, and then it was like, okay, we gotta go.
Congratulations! How fun for you!
Today's gonna be the day that they're gonna get. You know, Shana, for all my craziness and the no plan, no, you never know what might happen, and the ups and downs and lefts and rights and every which way I'm running, and there's one thing that's always, always solid and that I can always count on, and that's Shana and Chloe and being at home and in this house and her being here. And that's one thing I know I can always go to that will always be the same and that I can count on to be sound, versus everything else is always crazy and running around me, but every now and then I know I can come sit down at home with Shana and just be with her. She's like my getaway from everything else.
I'm pinching my leg so I don't cry. He keeps me from being so serious, and keeps me on my toes for sure. But I can be pretty intense and strict and scheduled, and he's the complete opposite and keeps me from falling into a pattern of habit. It's almost the exact, almost the same thing. It's like I can count on him always cheering me up or providing exactly the right mood, and always keeping me from being so serious, and just kind of just puts me in check a little bit when I turn into like an old adult. So, yeah.
Cheers, great friends, good times, and future to come.
Woo! Get married, get hitched.
So, the wedding will be this coming May 23rd, 2015. We're not sure the exact time yet, but it'll be that evening, and it'll be at my Uncle Bob and Aunt Vicky's Green Acres Ranch, just outside the Pister. We'll be sure and send that address to everybody so you know how to get there.
After the wedding, is there anything you can think of?
You're having a baby! Oh.
That's what she looks most forward to.
And the wedding.
That and tomato soup.
Yeah, I love tomato soup. It's my favorite kind of soup. It is? Mm-hmm.